Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today is going to be a short and sweet but informative video, and I'm going to show you 5 must-have makeup palettes for the beginner makeup artist. But before we get into that, I quickly want to tell you guys about Skillshare, since they are sponsoring this video.
Skillshare is an online learning community where millions come together to take the next step in their creative journey. With thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people on topics including illustration, design, photography, video, freelancing, and many more. Something I really like about Skillshare is that it has classes to fit your schedule and skill level, and most of the classes are also under 60 minutes with short lessons. Here's a few classes I've been taking since my interest for Dutch culture and the language has really grown recently. But in the Skillshare search tab, you can search for any of your interests and I'm sure you will definitely find something. And of course, I have a special offer for you guys. The first 500 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get 2 free months of premium membership so you can explore your creativity. So join me and many others on Skillshare and let's learn something new.
As a beginner makeup artist, you do not have a lot of money to spend on a lot of different palettes. So it can be very hard deciding on a palette to choose from because, I mean, there are so many. So I thought I would narrow down my selection of favorite palettes to 5 to show you which ones you should spend your money on. So in at number 5, we have the Catrice Pro Slim Eyeshadow Palette. So I actually included 2 because these are, I don't know if it's a new formula, but Catrice have really brought the game with these palettes. They even have some pressed pigments in there. This one is a bit more warmer and this one is slightly a bit more cool toned, but the color payoff is so nice. The mattes blend really well. They're also pretty pigmented. You have shimmers, you have mattes, you have the pressed pigments. Really great for budget friendly girl if you're just starting out in the makeup industry, and also I'm sure you can create a lot of beautiful looks with these palettes. In at number 4 is Makeup Revolution, and you can find this at Clicks. This is the Forever Flawless Decadent palette, and the reason why I love it so much is you have all these beautiful warm shades. You've got shimmers, coppers, golds, rose gold, orangey, pinky, reddy, browny sort of undertones, and then of course this absolutely beautiful pearl color, which is just so nice for highlighting the inner corner. With this, you can create a lot of looks because people really enjoy warm looks now. And I must say, actually, most of Makeup Revolution's products are really good quality and also budget friendly at the same time. Now, in number 3, and this product is only available in South Africa, proudly South African, it is the Switch Beauty Slays for Days palette. Now, I think this palette is known by everyone in South Africa. It is probably owned by every makeup artist in South Africa as well. And when I show you what it looks like, you will absolutely understand. There we go, friends. Now, this is a staple item in my kit. And the reason why is because it's filled with so many transition colors for any skin tone, for any look. You've got some cool tones, you've got some warm tones, you've got some shimmers, gold, coppers, rosy colors, some gorgeous nude mattes. I mean, the possibilities are endless with this. I must say, however, on some of the products, I would have liked a little bit more pigment, but it's really great for using as a transition palette for any sort of look. And I constantly go through these. This is like my 3rd palette already, and I would highly recommend it. Once again, budget friendly. Now the next product coming in at number 2 is an Urban Decay palette. Now I know it's not as budget friendly, however, if you do have the money to splurge on one of the Naked palettes, this is the one I would recommend. It is the Naked 2, another staple in my kit, especially this black. You guys, this black It's darker than my polar neck. This palette has got amazing pigments, from matte going really dark, and you have a lot of cool tones as well. But then you also have the gold and the rose gold glittery sort of shimmer color, and it's so beautiful to create a lot of looks with. It's one that you will grab very often, and you will definitely get your money's worth out of this one. Just make sure that you buy it from an authentic Urban Decay store. If you Google Urban Decay stores in South Africa, they will pop up a list of where there are stores, and you can also buy it online, urbandecay.co.za, or even at Fushini online. So never buy from anyone else but Urban Decay to make sure that you don't end up with a fake one. But Naked 2 is like my most used naked palette in my kit. Coming in at number one, can we have a drum roll? Of course, if you guys know me, it's gonna be an Urban Decay palette, and it is the Born to Run from Urban Decay. What makes this my number one palette is because if you have the money to only buy this palette, I am almost sure that you will be able to create any makeup look your client wants. And here's why. They basically designed it to be a palette on the go. So it's a palette you can grab and you can create lots of looks with. And if you look at it, you can actually really see you've got some beautiful transition colors, gold shimmers, highlighter shades. We've got a pink in there. We've got a purple. We've got black. We've got browns, shimmer, and matte. We've got an orange, we've got purple and violet, we have blues and like a turquoisey green and a bit more of a deeper forest green. So the looks you can create with this is endless. And when you know someone whips up a photo of a beautiful green look, you have it. If they want like some blue on the outer corner, you have it. If they just want a beautiful soft bridal look, you have it. You can create anything with this palette, and I absolutely feel like if you invest in this, you will not regret it at all. Also, when I travel, I always take this out of my kit and I pop it in my bag, because it's the only palette I feel comfortable traveling with, knowing that I can create any makeup look. So that's it for my top 5 makeup palettes. Let me know in the comment section down below what other palettes you really love and really enjoy. Let me know if you would like more videos on my top 5 picks for beginner makeup artists. But as always, until my next video, stay sweet. I'll talk to you soon.